This is Nina Curley from Wamna Media. I'm here chatting with Jeff Ramsey, the founder of eMarketer, an online digital advertising and marketing intelligence site. Jeff, how are you?
I'm great. It's great to be in this part of the world. It's my first time in the Middle East.
Welcome. How have you been enjoying the summit so far?
Oh, this has been fantastic. I go to a lot of conferences just to network. But this is a conference where I'm not only networking, I'm also learning a great deal. There's nothing like having your feet on the ground to understand culturally what's happening, economically what's happening, to actually feel the energy that people are having towards digital and the desire for growth and entrepreneurship. It's really fantastic to be a part of this.
So why did you start eMarketer?
I had been working in the advertising business for 17 years, and it was really completely by accident. My three partners and I in the mid-90s were in the context of an advertising agency helping our clients build websites, because everybody needed a website back in the mid-90s. They didn't know why, they just needed one. And so my partner decided that we would create a web portal for other businesses to understand about this internet thing. And quite frankly, you know, I'm called a visionary, but I didn't think this internet thing was gonna take off. But the more I dug in and read the statistics about it, the more confused I became, because it seemed like every researcher and analyst firm out there had a different idea about where it was today and where it was going. And so I reported on that, and we saw all the traffic on our website go to the stuff I was essentially blogging about before blogs existed. And then that turned into writing a report that kind of flew off the shelves back then. This was before the dot-com bust. And essentially, the rest is history. Started creating this content that we now charge for because people want intelligence. There's lots of information out there, but there's a lot of misinformation. And so we need filters to dissect and synthesize what's going on.
Absolutely. Intelligence sells.
Yes.
How do you monetize the site?
Essentially, there's the public website and our free newsletter, where a lot of people know us around the world because of those free things, which are really just promotional outreaches that gather awareness for this for us. But our main model or engine for our monetization is a subscription model where companies pay to get access. But at the same time, 15% is advertising supported, and we very much like that business, and it's very profitable.
I see. So it's mostly subscription, a little dose of advertising.
And they feed each other, because the advertising supports our other business, because people hear about us through the ad-supported model, and they get the free newsletter, they get hooked in that, and then they want more information, so then they come and they eventually want to pay.
Right. So in a given market, you know, is there a tipping point after which it becomes easier to create digital content and monetize it? What does it take to get to that tipping point?
Yeah, generally speaking, I don't think there are any hard and fast rules, but in any given geographic market, you essentially have to have, I would say, at least about a 50% penetration of broadband. You have to have enough connectivity and speed with at least half of the population before you can have enough consumption to support some kind of monetization model, whether it's advertising supported or pay for content, or if you have enough, not just mobile penetration, but smartphone penetration. In fact, in our statistics yesterday, I said that globally, the penetration of smartphone users will grow from 24% to about 54%. So we're going to see a doubling in the growth rate or penetration of smartphones. And I think that will be a huge leap forward for the world in terms of connectivity and the monetization of content.
Is this going to hit the emerging markets harder than the developed markets?
I'd say it's going to be more beneficial for the emerging markets, because they're going to have an infusion of new content, customized content, personalized content for those regions of the world. And there will be much more growth, albeit it's off of a smaller base. But what we see is the maturing markets are growing, but not as rapidly as the emerging markets. And so the growth opportunities are definitely in developing parts of the world, like here.
Absolutely. And any insights that you've gathered about the Middle East, North African market, or that you'd like to share?
Simply that I think we're going to see a lot of changes over the next few years, and even eMarketer, which makes predictions about all things digital, can't really predict how fast it's going to happen or in what ways, but it's a very exciting market to be in. I think as we tell our clients, you really have to be in the region and pay attention to it to understand where it's going, and there's surprises every corner, but it's great to actually be here and feel the vibration.
Thanks so much for chatting with Wamda.
Very nice to be here. Thank you.